Good afternoon, guys. My name is Kenny, and you're watching Brave the Wilds on YouTube. What I want to do today is dedicate a video to an American-made axe company that I've discovered and gotten a chance to use some of their products over the past 3 to 6 months. One of them was by chance, and another one was after doing some talking with them and collaboration with the company itself, because I was impressed with them and had a connection with my good friend Henry from Burke Brothers Hardware Store. We were able to get a hold of Council Tool Company and do a plant tour of their facility. If you guys aren't aware, Council Tool Company is an American-based axe company mainly. They do a lot of things, but they are known for their axes, and that's kind of what they started on. And they're based out of Lake Waccamaw, North Carolina, and they are over 100 years old, and they're still operating out of the same area, the same basically shore by the Lake Waccamaw area itself. They have a little facility there, which is where they've been manufacturing axes and other tools for over 100 years. If you guys are interested in the company itself, or you'd like to look at an interview or a plant tour, I have videos on both of those. If you look at the bottom of your screen, you'll see a interview with the Vice President, Ms. Pickett Council, and you will also see a plant tour where we go through and just look at some of the facility pieces of equipment that they have and things like that as well. So basically, I have two different sizes, or two different types of axes. Both of them are 36-inch full-size axes. They're both 3.5 pounds, and one of them is a splitting axe, and one of them is a felling axe. The first one is the splitting axe, and you guys may recognize this. This axe I did a restoration on a couple months ago on my channel, and you can click the video at the bottom of your screen to take you to that video as well, where I fully restore this axe head right here. I got this axe head quite a while ago. I can't remember exactly how I got it. I got quite a few around the same time, so I can't remember exactly how I came about this one. But I do know that it was painted, and it was in good shape, actually, for how old it is. I'm not quite sure how old it is, but I know it's pretty old, and it's in very good shape. There's not a whole lot of pitting or anything like that, so I decided that I would go ahead and restore it. So you guys, if you haven't already, I encourage you to check out that video where I go through the full restoration. I've polished the axe head, and then I also hang it on a 36-inch handle, which I believe this also you can get at Burke Brothers. It is a Council Tool Company handle, I do believe, as well. They ship those into the store as well, I believe. And, you know, I've been using this thing as my primary splitter for 6 months now, and I've been absolutely amazed with it. I sharpened this thing about 3 months ago, and I've split about half a cord of wood. In the meantime, just doing small splitting for things like getting ready for campouts and stuff like that. And I have not had to touch the edge, and I can tell you right now there's absolutely no nicks, and there's no folds in this edge whatsoever. Now, I take good care of my axes, and you don't, you know, land them in the dirt, things like that, and hit a bunch of rocks. So I have been careful with it to make sure that, you know, I'm not doing side swipes and then nicking off and hitting, you know, rocks and dirt. You know, I've been making sure to take care of this tool, because axes will last a lifetime if you take care of them. And so I didn't actually realize what company it was until about a month later, when people were leaving comments on the YouTube video that, you know, that's a Council Tool Company axe handle or axe head. And so I did a little bit of research and really liked the company, and that was around the same time that I was talking with Mr. Henry Burke from Burke Brothers, and he in his store has a wall of Council Tool Company axes and some other products, and he's got a little bit of information and history about the company, because it is very unique to have a company that's been around for over 100 years in the same area still making products in the USA with the same quality that they've always made. So I thought that was interesting, and we decided we would make a trip and go to Lake Waccamaw and kind of see what's going on there and do, you know, plant tour and things like that. And so that is where I picked up the second axe. This is also a 36-inch, and this is a Velvacut felling axe. I'm not exactly sure what the name of it is. I do know that the model line is Velvacut, which you can see on the picture right here. And this is definitely a felling style axe. I'm not sure the exact name of it, but as far as the use is concerned, I can tell you it is a splitting axe, or a felling axe, excuse me. Because if you will look at the tapers between these two, you can tell the difference in height, obviously, and total length of the felling axe it is much longer. The taper on it is much shallower, which is meant for biting into wood deep. And I'll be honest with you, I have never had an axe that bites this deep into wood ever in my life. I've never used one that works this well. I'm not sure what the name of the steel is that they use. I believe it's 5160. Don't quote me on that. But the steel that they use has blown me away. I've sharpened this thing once in the 3 months that I've had it. And I've done quite a bit of felling with it. Doing a lot of just cutting up branches and stuff for fires and things like that. And I am beyond impressed. I was actually clearing a campsite when I went camping on my last camping trip, backpacking overnight in the wintertime, about two or three videos back if you guys are interested on my channel. I've got that series if you want. And, you know, I was actually cutting about an inch and a half, inch and three-quarter sapling, and I went to cut it, and normally it takes, you know, two, three, four, five, maybe six chops to cut a sapling down, you know, about this size. Well, I went to use this thing, and I sliced right through it in the first hit, and I actually did end up putting it in the ground and putting a really small fold there. Completely my fault, I hit a rock, but it did fold, not chip, so it'll be easy to roll that back over and be good to go. But it just impressed me because I was not expecting that thing to cut right through it. So with that being said, these two axes have been my primary use axes as far as full-size axes go for about 3 to 6 months. I've had this one for about half as long as I've had this one, and I've had absolutely zero complaints. And I'll make a comment here really quickly. Council Tool Company did give me this axe right here. They did not give me this axe. This axe is completely me. I did this myself. If it was not to be that I were to talk with Council Tool and they were to send me this axe, I would still recommend this axe right here. I would be sitting here doing a review on this axe right now because I believe in the quality of these tools, and I'm not just sitting here telling you what the company wants me to say. I'm here telling you that from my practical experience and knowledge and use of these tools, I am very impressed with the quality, and I do not think you will go wrong whatsoever purchasing a Council Tool Company anything, whether that's axes, sledgehammers, really any of their tools. You will not go wrong with quality. You can see exactly how they make them on that Council Plant Tour video. You will see the exact same pieces of equipment that they've been using, some of them over 80 years, to build these same tools. So the quality is definitely there. So, you know, if you are in the market for a full-size axe that is not, you know, you don't necessarily have the time to find an axe head at a flea market, refurbish it, put a handle on it, maybe you don't have the skill set, maybe you don't have the tools, maybe you don't have the time, you don't have to go overseas to Sweden to get a high-quality axe head. They're still making, in America today, high-quality axe heads at a good price point. If you guys are interested and want to take a look around and see what other products Council carries, click the link at the bottom of the screen here, and that will take you to the Burke Brothers website, where they do carry quite a few different Council axes. And then also, Council Tool Company has their own website if you want to check out some of the other things they carry as well. So, you know, for the price, I really don't think you can go wrong. The attention to detail on these is very nice. They do a type of process on these axe heads to give them a vintage look, because a lot of them, you know, what they used to do when they manufactured them was make them, you know, just absolutely spotless. And, you know, they like the vintage look and the vintage style of axes, because that's, you know, the traditional way axes, you know, used to be made by hand, and that type of feel is what they like, and I like it as well. And so they've done this process where they take it and they kind of create a rough basically face on the axe to give it a kind of a vintage handmade look, and I really like it. I think they pulled it off well. It doesn't look overdone. It doesn't look intentional per se, is the best way to put it. If you buy any of the Velva Cuts, they also come in the sheath. I'm not sure what exactly. I'm pretty sure you get some type of sheath with all of their tools, obviously cutting tools. So you do get a sheath. And, you know, I really don't think you can go wrong. I think this felling axe has been very well thought out because, you know, the handle on it that they use is very well balanced. And I think the size of the handle, the thickness and the bulk in your hands, fits this style head very well. This axe right here has a much thicker grip to it because it's a bit bulkier of a head. It's a thicker head because it's smaller, and it's thicker because it gets you the more taper for splitting. And so I like having a bulkier handle for that. But for doing fine felling, where you can try and get a lot of speed on it, and you want that kind of thinner handle, I really think this delivers that for you. And, you know, they really stand behind their products. If you're ever having a problem with any of them, just contact them and they'll take care of you. And, you know, like I said, Council did not ask me to make this video. I'm just doing this specifically to tell you guys and inform you that, you know, there are still American-made axes today that are produced with high quality and attention to detail. I've spoken personally with the vice president of the company, and I can tell you she knows her stuff about axes, and she cares about them. She has passion, and that goes for anybody in that company. They really take pride in the tools that they make. They're not there to just produce products to make money. They're there to produce high quality tools that are heritage and will last for generations and generations if taken care of properly. So, just wanted to do a quick video on that. Like I said, all the links and videos are down at the bottom of the screen right now. I'll go ahead and put them all there. If you guys are interested in any of that stuff and you want to check it out, feel free. Please go ahead and subscribe if you haven't already so you can be updated on all the videos that I produce. Also, hit the like button if you could. I would really appreciate it. And until then, on the next video, I'll see you around and take care.